I don't know whether you believe it or not, but the world's largest solar park is the Bhadla Solar Park in Rajasthan, India. This image shows the area before the solar park, and this one shows it after the solar park's installation. Just imagine, this small area covers nearly 14,000 acres and can generate over 2.2 gigawatts of solar power. The fact that this capacity could potentially fulfill the energy requirements of a major city like Mumbai. Friends, hope you are very excited. I also excited. In this video, we will try to understand what a solar park is exactly and how it generates power. In simple terms, a solar park is an area of land where many solar panels are installed. A single solar panel can produce a small amount of electricity, but when solar panels are connected in series, they form what is called a solar array, and it produces usable voltage. In this configuration, the positive terminal of one panel is connected to the negative terminal of the next panel, creating a chain that increases the voltage output of the array. Now, let's take a look at the structure of a single solar array. In larger solar arrays, multiple strings of solar panels are connected in parallel. The wiring from each string is then combined in a combiner box, which collects the DC electricity from all the strings and directs it toward the next stage of the system. The collected DC electricity is then fed into an inverter, which converts it into alternating current AC electricity. This conversion is necessary because most electrical appliances and the grid operate on AC power. The grid serves as an interconnected network that distributes electricity from power plants to consumers, ensuring reliable and efficient delivery of power. It facilitates the balancing of supply and demand, allowing for real-time adjustments to meet fluctuating energy needs. In this stage, high-voltage or step-up transformers are used to increase the voltage for transmitting power over long distances with the help of these towers. Some solar plants utilize battery banks. It is used to store excess electricity generated during periods of sunlight for later use when sunlight is unavailable. Batteries are safely installed inside these cabinets, ensuring secure storage and operation. Battery banks are typically installed before or after the inverter stage in a solar power system. Once the electricity generated by solar panels is converted from direct current, DC, to alternating current, AC, by the inverter, any excess energy can be stored in the battery bank for later use. A solar panel consists of multiple layers designed to protect the panel, with solar cells being the primary components. Solar cells are composed of semiconductor materials such as silicon. When sunlight penetrates the solar panel, it generates electricity, typically in the form of direct current, DC. Friends, if you want to gain the knowledge how does solar cell generate this DC current, comment below. I will back soon. Thank you. Let's grow up. Never stop learning.